We're going to talk now about meiosis, which is the process by which a single cell that has two chromosomes in it, let's say, for example, chromosome one from the father and chromosome one from the mother, so we have a diploid organism. Each of these lines, again, representing a double-stranded double helix. How this cell can create gametes that are used for fertilization to pass those genes on to future generations. And you probably already understand that the process of meiosis involves taking a diploid cell and producing four haploid cells, the gametes, be it sperm or egg, depending on the sex that you are. And each of these gametes, then haploid, means that instead of having two copies of every chromosome, they will just have a single copy of every chromosome. So they'll either have the paternal version or the maternal version. There will always be one copy of the chromosome in each gamete, and only one or the other, paternal or maternal version. And meiosis is the pathway through which this happens. So the first step of meiosis is, as you, in mitosis, so this is a similarity between the two, synthesis. So we have a situation where we have four copies of chromosome one, the two paternal and the two maternal versions, and this is called a tetrad for four copies of chromosome all lined up together. And the sister chromatids, the two paternal versions of the molecules of DNA, are held together more tightly, and the two maternal versions are held together more tightly than the paternal two DNA molecules to the two maternal DNA molecules. So the first division, we're temporarily in a tetrad, we're temporarily in a state where the cell is tetraploid. It's got four copies of each chromosome, and of course that's what we want, because we need four copies of each chromosome to produce the four gametes that are a result of meiosis. So now we have to have two cell divisions. We're going to have the first division, where we go from one cell to two. And the only thing that you have to remember here is how these four chromosomes segregate into two cells. Do the two paternal versions go into one, the two maternal go into the other cell, or is it one paternal and one paternal per cell? Well, remember I said that the two sister chromatids, the two paternals, are held together more tightly than the tetrad as a whole. So at the first division, for one chromosome, we get both of the paternal versions of the chromosome go into one cell, and both of the maternal versions go into the other cell. The second division is where this cell will divide down the middle, and so will that cell, so we wind up getting four individual cells, each of which contain one copy of this chromosome. A really important point to take away from this model is that if you're a diploid organism, you can only have two alleles of each chromosome. You have a paternal version, you have a maternal version, which means you can only have two types of haplotypes. You can have the haplotype, which is the genotype of a haploid gamete that's paternal, and you can have a haplotype that's maternal. So if you have four cells, and if you have two haplotypes, you do the math. That means that there are going to be two cells that have one haplotype and two cells that have the other. Guaranteed. There's never going to be a situation where there's paternal, 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 and one maternal. It's always going to be exactly half of the gametes that carry the paternal allele, and the other half of the gametes will carry the maternal allele of each chromosome. This is the meiotic basis for one of Mendel's laws. This is the law of segregation of alleles into gametes at meiosis.